This is the YGTV News with Georgina White.
Welcome to the YGTV News. These are the main headlines today on Monday the 7th of May. I'm Georgina White. Chief Minister calls SVA and RGP incident lamentable. St. Bernadette's Resource Centre farm visit. Field gun crew hold public display in competition preparation. Ocean Village to host Jubilee Floatilla. And finally, 3rd of May lottery results. An incident occurred last Wednesday involving a Servicio de Vigilancia Aduanera, SVA, assisting navigators of illegal ribs in Gibraltar waters. According to the RGP, they were informed that the Spanish SVA had stopped a rib with three occupants just off Europa Point. The vessel was then untied by the SVA and the RGP carried out a document check of the individuals on the rib. After informing the SVA of the correct protocol in these incidents, they were told that protocol was not followed by the RGP in Spanish waters. At this point, two other ribs were seen around the bay. The incident saw the RGP attempt to arrest the occupants of the vessels, but the SVA launch and illegal vessels eventually got away. Speaking on the incident, Chief Minister Fabian Bicardo noted that it was lamentable. The British government has also written a diplomatic complaint to the Spanish government about the episode. As reported last week, St. Bernadette's Resource Centre visited El Parque de las Aves in Jimena on Friday. During lunch and the afternoon activities, the group was joined by Minister for Social Services, Samantha Sacramento. YGTV spoke to the minister during the visit.
Good afternoon, Minister Sacramento. Thank you for talking to YGTV. What was the aim of today's visit?
This is a visit that's been organised by St. Bernadette's Resource Centre. It was planned a long time ago. In fact, they've been fundraising to attend this event for over a year. And an event such as this, I think it's 19 service users have attended this. It's a Granja Escuela Las Aves, and it's a wildlife centre, but it's also a working farm. And lots of school trips are organised here, but this is particularly helpful for St. Bernadette's Resource Centre, given that it will stimulate a lot of the service users with different disabilities. Today is quite a landmark event because the majority of the service users at St. Bernadette's have attended. I understand that 19 of them are here. Obviously, an event such as this takes a lot of planning, and management have been liaising with the staff here at the Palque for a couple of months to make sure that all the needs of the service users are taken care of.
What kind of activities have the service users been carrying out today?
They've had a trip around the wildlife park. There's lots of different animals here. Then they've also been driven on tractors. There's been a wildlife show involving some birds. I think that they've all had a photograph taken with a big owl. They're enjoying lunch at the moment, and there's going to be a craft workshop straight after lunch. And that again will the majority of the service users will participate, and that will give them some stimulation, and they'll be able to take their crafts home with them.
Thank you very much for speaking to us.
No problem.
The Gibraltar field gun crew is inviting members of the public to watch its final preparations on Saturday the 12th of May, prior to the annual field gun competition in Portsmouth. At around noon, 8 Royal Navy, 8 RAF and 5 Army personnel will pull the 2,200 pounds of gun and timber from Casemate Square up through Main Street. They will be accompanied by the Corps of Drums of the Royal Gibraltar Regiment. On arrival at the naval base at approximately 12:30, the crew will begin a series of adrenaline-fueled public runs watched by invited guests, senior members of the government and His Excellency the Governor. As part of the summer's Diamond Jubilee celebrations, Ocean Village is hosting a flotilla similar to that of London's Thames Diamond Jubilee pageant. YGTV spoke to Ross Astengo for more information.
Thank you very much for speaking to us here at YGTV. Obviously, we're slowly approaching the Diamond Jubilee celebration time. How has Ocean Village got involved with this flotilla? And tell us a bit about what a flotilla is.
Okay, but we wanted to do something to celebrate the Queen's Diamond Jubilee. We weren't quite sure what we wanted to do, and then we saw that the Thames were doing a flotilla along the Thames, and of boats, a lot of super yachts are heading on their way to London to join the flotilla, also for the Olympics as well. And we thought, well, that's something that we can do over here as well. It would be an ideal, we own a marina here, so it would be an ideal opportunity to have a flotilla around the Rock of Gibraltar. And also, I know that we have a lot of British people who berth here in the marina and also all along the Costa del Sol. And I'm sure a lot of them would like to join in and celebrate the Queen's Diamond Jubilee, but don't want to make that long journey back home. So very conveniently, we're having our own flotilla around the Rock of Gibraltar, and they can all join in, not just Brits, anybody who wants to join in.
And will the whole of Ocean Village be getting involved? Will this be, you know, bars and clubs?
Yeah, we've got several restaurants who are doing special Diamond Jubilee meals on the day, on the 4th of June. There's going to be live music on Leisure Island. There's going to be DJ chill-out music Savannah are doing in the evening. We are doing a drink celebration for all the crews taking part in the flotilla. And on Leisure Island, there's also going to be a typical English cake stall. Customers will be served tea by the Queen, not the Queen herself, but someone who looks remarkably like her. And they'll be selling strawberries and scones and all the typical English tea cakes as well. So it's going to be a nice day in Ocean Village. Hopefully the weather will be great. The flotilla will kick off at midday. So we're hoping that people will come down and see all the boats off. They'll all be sounding their horns and just enjoy the rest of the day in Ocean Village until they get back.
And how can boats get involved with this? Where can they sign up?
Well, they need to email Ocean Village on peeroffice@oceanvillage.gi. They can also log in into our website, www.oceanvillage.com/flotilla, to find out more details. And basically all they need to do is to register their boat. It's completely free to take part. It's not competitive. It's just going to be a great fun day. The flotilla is actually going to be led by a Royal Navy light vessel. Our Royal Gibraltar Police Marine Section also going to have a vessel there leading the way. So it's going to be a great day.
Definitely something that people should take part in then.
Yeah, we hope so. And those who would like to take part in the flotilla but don't actually have a boat can charter boats. We have boats that can be chartered in the marina, so they just have to get in touch with us here at the pier office and we can put them in touch with a charter boat. But also, if you want to stay on land, if like myself you tend to get a bit seasick and you'd rather be on shore, the flotilla will be going around the Rock of Gibraltar from the western side of the runway all the way around where Europa Point is, weather permitting, round to the eastern side of the runway. So, you know, wherever you are in Gibraltar, you can possibly just stand on shore, wave your flag, sound your horns, and just greet the flotilla as it goes by.
And finally, last Thursday's lottery draw saw ticket number 06627 win the first prize of £100,000. Ticket number 02998 won the second prize of £10,000, and ticket number 13352 won the third prize of £5,000. For all the minor prizes, check out our website at yourgibraltartv.com. That's the YGTV News. We're back tomorrow. See you then.